Now, before I ever bought my first drone, what sort of inspired me to get one and the craving I had was to be able to fly around at maybe a couple of 100 feet, see something on the ground, and just dive down, investigate, have a closer look. Literally having a bird's eye view and then doing exactly what a bird would do if it wanted. You've got that free will to go and have a look. So, and I forgot all about that idea as I've been going along and making different videos. And somebody said to me a couple of weeks ago, "Oh, it'd be fantastic if you could fly down and just see something on the land and go and explore it." And I suddenly remembered the way I'd imagined that feeling would be, and I had forgotten. So I've decided to do one. And in this video now, at about 12 o'clock, as I'm flying over this beautiful Welsh countryside, I see a couple of vehicles. So I'm gonna get myself over there, fly on down, take a look around, see what transpires. Here we go, getting a bit closer now. Looks to me to be three vehicles. As you can see, it's getting a bit darker now, with the A55 starting to light up nicely there. So let's start reducing the altitude and have a little look, and hopefully we can get a little fly around the area. And as we're sort of panning to the right now, you can see the altitude is coming down. So altitude's being adjusted, the yaw has been adjusted to the left a touch there, and will be as I'm losing altitude coming into the field. As I'm getting closer to the vehicles, my pitch will be going up. So this sort of speed is ideal to hone them drone skills, because you're sort of going maybe through a couple of three dimensions all at the same time. So the key is keeping it very slow, taking your time, keeping your eyes open, and keeping everything as smooth as you can. So it's not three vehicles, it's four. Not sure if it's just trailers or there's a cab anyway. Let's go. Let's get further down. Have a good look. And as we're coming in closer again, it's clear to see this is actually part of the Circus Mondeo gang, who've obviously moved on. There's a massive Heavy and Drag there. The trailer on that with the circus sign on top looks like a living accommodation of sorts. The other two trailers on the other side look like they're just going to be picked up by a tractor unit. So let's see if I can get myself around the front and potentially get a bit closer to these vehicles. It's a gorgeous evening, as you can see. Hardly any wind at all. So let's see how close we dare get. So I think you can see what's going through my mind now. Shall I? Shan't I? Shall I have a go? Keep it slow, keep your eyes open, and let's go for it. Will I get right through the middle? Slow, 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 slow. Left hand side jutting out a touch there, so we'll pop it over a touch. Yes. Now that felt amazing. So I'm going to swoop back up now into the sky, have a little look around, watching that tree on my left, because I'll be coming over to the left a touch sideways there, yawing round to the right, and survey the scene from a bit of a different angle now. Beautiful. So let's get a little lower, a little slower, and have a little fly over them once again. I love doing this. I love editing. I love the flying, but it'd be really nice to know that someone's actually having a little look in. If you hate it, let me know. Give me ideas. What would be better? If you like it, let me know. So stay safe. Take care. I'm just going to pop over these trees. You're around to the right, so I can see over the 55, over the sea, and you can see in the distance to the right coming into screen now, Puffin Island. So stay safe, take care, and thank you for watching.